Well, what is up, beautiful people of YouTube? My name is Yurtastic, and today I'm going to answer a question I get asked by my viewers and my subscribers, which is, what do you use to record your videos, and what are the settings that you use? So let's get into it. Well, hello there, J Army and the rest of the world. So today we are going to be covering, obviously, what I use for what I record. If you haven't guessed already, I use OBS. So today I'm going to talk to you about the OBS settings, what I feel like are the best OBS settings, what I use for my OBS settings, what are OBS scenes, what are OBS sources, all this stuff. We're going to go into it. So this is basically an OBS tutorial for beginners. I'm going to give you those settings that I feel like is best for my computer build and recommend what you should do for your computer build if you have a low-end one or a medium-built one, and we'll go from there. So basically, we're going to cover what are scenes and what they are, my settings, what the best settings I think are, and how to configure your audio. So let's get it started. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so what are scenes? Let's start off with what is OBS, or what are OBS scenes? As you can see right here, scenes are basically a collection of sources, whether it's graphic sources, media sources that includes videos, songs, animations, stream layer, whatnot. Like, for example, if I was about to have stream starting soon, blah, 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 that picture would go in the stream starting source. I don't want to click on that scene because we're displaying a capture, and the display capture is in the middle scene. So if I go here, it's going to go blank. So we're going to focus on the middle scene for right now. For example, in the middle scene, as you can see, my camera is here. If my camera was connected, I click on this, it'll show my camera border. This is where it is. So these what are considered sources to the scene. So that's exactly what scene is. A stream animation is right there, become a part of JRM, and of course you can always become part of JRM even right now, but that's what basically it is. So scenes are where you can customize your video. So it depends on what your needs are. Are you a streamer, or you just record videos, or you do both? For example, in my case, I do both. So I have a streaming starting, a streaming ending scene, and I have the regular one in the middle that I go when I'm streaming. This includes the stream animations, the camera, the subs, blah, blah, blah. How to add a scene, or how to add a source in OBS, is simply go on here, and you got it all here. If it's an image, it's pretty self-explanatory. Click an image, go to the file location, it's here, it becomes here, you can rename it. Display capture is what displays, what captures your display, pretty simple. Game capture is to capture your game. You can also record your game by display capture, but not the best frames for that. Music or videos is classified under media source, so you click on that, and here's the media sources that I have here, etc., so on and so forth. Or you can export, create a new one, make sure you name it so it can be organized. I have here like a 1021. This one I was in a 5M server where you cannot, you know, it would display a message saying I'm in a 1021, private talk, blah, 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 the stream is muted, or the video is muted. So these are what scenes are, and this is how you do them, and this is how you get to them in OBS. Pretty self-explanatory here, nothing to talk about. Now let's get to the part that I'm sure a lot of you are here for, which is the settings within OBS. So let's go ahead and open the settings folder in case you don't know where it's at. You can either go file settings, or you can go settings on the right hand side. So here we are in the settings section right now. Let me just go ahead and make this bigger. So here we are with settings. You got the general, don't touch anything here, and I'll go tab by tab. Don't touch anything in general, leave it as it is. There's maybe some little things here and there that are custom to you, but for the most part, don't touch anything here. Stream, if you plan on streaming, you click or you select the source, if it's YouTube, Twitch, Mixer, etc., and you get your stream key. Obviously, I can't show you my stream key. If you don't know how to get your stream key, make sure you Google how. That has to do with your YouTube channel. And output is where we're going to be touching a lot of bass. Before we go to streaming, let's go to recording. As you can see, a lot of the things are highlighted, not highlighted for me, because I am recording right now. So first and foremost, you want to go ahead and type standard recording path, select the path that you want. Preferably, if you have an extra hard drive that you're not playing games on, just put it to that hard drive, just so you can have your games on one drive, processing on one drive, and your video being written or recorded on another drive. That's what I like to do. Recording format, MP4 is a standard one. Go ahead and stick to MP4. As far as audio tracks, don't get too fancy. I've been doing 450 videos on YouTube with just audio track, one audio track. You don't gotta get too fancy. unless you want the game audio and your audio completely separate, then that's fine. But we'll get to the audio section in just a second after this. So I will just leave it at one for now. Encoder, what I use is Nvidia NVENC H264 new. Now this is basically tells OBS to go and use your GPU instead of your CPU in case you don't have the best CPU. And even if you do have the best CPU, most GPUs have way more cores than a CPU and are just fine with recording OBS. Rescale output depends on your monitor. I have a 1920 by 1080 75 hertz monitor, so I have that there. Now we come here, this is where the technical jargon starts. CPR, blah blah blah, there's a lot of talk about what's best. Now, lossless is almost impossible, even though I have an i9-9900K and a 2070 Super RTX. Lossless is gonna really be kind of hard to capture unless you have an extreme computer, okay? CQP, I would skip it. Now, the debate is usually between CPR, variable bitrate, and constant bitrate. A lot of people swear that VPR is way higher quality, and I can tell you it probably is, but by 5 to 10% margin. And VPR makes your files extremely bigger, and that means bigger upload size for YouTube if that's what you're doing. And it's, to me, just was not worth what it was giving me. It wasn't worth what it was giving me between a CPR and a VPR. So I would just go with CPR, constant bitrate. The bitrate we're going with here is 16,500. I can probably honestly go up to 19,000, but I like to stay in the safe side. I like to maybe sacrifice 5 to 8% of quality. Maybe I would, 8% is maybe extreme. I would like to sacrifice 5% of quality and just make sure I have better frames that are more fluid and enjoyable. I could probably go to 19,000, but if you have a high-end PC, then you should probably shoot between 16,000 to 19,000. A medium NPC, you should probably shoot between 10,000 to 13,000. And a low NPC, you should probably shoot between 5,000, 8,000, hell, sometimes even 4,000 to 6,000. So these are the OBS settings that I recommend as far as CPR and bitrate, okay? It is trial and error. You could try it. Maybe you don't have the best PC, but maybe your GPU is somehow better. You know, try going up. It is trial and error. Use it a lot. This is how I got to this number. So I'm comfortable 16.5. Some people go up to 18.5, which I've done, and it worked fine for me. But I wanted to say 16.5. So like I said, high-end 16.5 to 18.5, even 20 if you want. Medium-end, let's just go between 10, 11 to 13.5. And high-end or low-end, let's go between 4 to 8. Let's not even try to go any higher than that. As far as keyframe interval per second, some people put 0 as auto. You can put 1, you can put 2. And this is really not really that necessary to me. Preset, once again, I can go max quality for my thing, but I go quality. And this is the one thing I want to kind of give you guys in mind, is that maybe your video is going to come out crispier, but it's going to be laggier for your audience. You might as well be on the safe side. So I go for quality. Once again, it depends on your computer. The higher computer is, the better it is. So for example, if you don't have a best computer, you might want to go max performance for the game. If you have a medium end one, you have a really low quality one, go low latency quality, and obviously lower and lower and lower. Okay, so it all depends, but for me, I go quality. Profile, either way, you could either go high or main, do not go baseline. And as far as look ahead, I don't have that checked. I didn't see it does anything by Psycho Visual Tuning. I have that checked on. A lot of people have look tuned in as well. I don't see the benefit in it. So that's just me. Now when it comes with a GPU, it says 0. If you have 2 GPUs, this basically telling OBS, which GPU do you want yours recorded from? Do you want it from, do you want to record it from the first slot GPU or the second slot GPU? If you have only one GPU, which a lot of you probably will have, just put it at 0. Max B frames set that to 2. So these are the settings for OBS. These are the bitrate settings. These are the rate control, the preset, the profile, etc., so on and so forth. Now we go to streaming. Streaming is a different game. I can go up a little higher, but this all has to do with your internet speed. Unfortunately, where I live, I have a really good download speed of 1 gig download, but get this, I only have 15 megabytes upload. They don't go very high for residential areas where I live. So unfortunately, my bitrate is tied to that. So in this case, once again, you got to look at 2 variables. The first thing you got to look at is how good is your computer? And the second thing you got to look at is how fast is your internet? In my case, 12.5 seems to be the sweet spot for me. If I go higher, my internet speed is not gonna catch up, but it's gonna start getting lag, and I'm gonna start skipping frames and what so on and whatnot. So that's what I got for stream. Now we're gonna go on to how to configure your OBS audio. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, now we go to OBS Audio. Before we get here, we got to go back to the front so I can show you what I'm talking about a little more. As you can see with the OBS Audio right here, you know, you have the main two things, which is the desktop audio that captures your gameplay, and you have your mic slash auxiliary audio. I have both muted, but if I was to unclick this, you will see my voice go up and down, right? I have it uncaptured because I capture my audio through Audacity. But anyways, you can capture audio through mic and through OBS, and I suggest you do that if you're just starting out, if you're a beginner OBS user. Now, with that being said, you have a desktop audio and capture audio. For example, if I was to, this is the video capture device, which I can just rename to my Elgato. If I put that, this also collects audio from my PS4 to here, but I don't have that on, so we leave it on. We'll keep it simple. So here's the audio. Pretty self-explanatory. You got your desktop audio and your mic audio. This is where you go to do it. Now we're gonna go into audio settings here before we go there. Now let's go on the audio here, okay? You're gonna have your desktop audio. Make sure you select which one it is. There's gonna be different ones. For the desktop audio, make sure you select it. How to test it? Well, just make sure you play like a song or something on YouTube or or just play anything in the background of your computer. And just make sure that this is picking it up. That's basically what it is. So for me, I have an M audio interface, so Fast Track 3. Same with my mic. I have M audio, it goes through my M audio as well, which I have an audio interface. So my mic and my desktop audio, my speakers go through the same interface. So that's why I see M audio Fast Track 3. For you, it's gonna be different, but make sure you select that. The same thing. Sample rate, make sure you go on 48 kilohertz, and the channels, make sure it's mono. Okay, nothing really else here. As long, like I said, as far as hotkeys, you can go ahead and make sure the hotkeys are correct for your needs, but nothing here. Fast, simple peak for the meters, you're good to go here. Now we go back to the audio settings over here. Now here's the thing that people don't understand with OBS, is that you can actually have filters within your audio tracks. For example, when I'm streaming, my audio or my microphone audio is going through OBS. So I go on filters, and if you can see here, these are things that I've added, the audio filters, and how to add an audio filter to your mic or to your voice. Basically, you click down here and you add compressor or gain, blah blah blah. In this case, I only use a gain and compressor. Don't touch them, just put them on and let it do its magic. There are other plugins that you can use, but this is what I use. So for the audio, you go here, it just makes it sound smoother and all that stuff. So compressor and gain are really your two best friends in this case. And that's it. For as far as desktop audio, I don't have any filters because the audio is just coming from the game. I don't need any filters there. So one more thing with the audio is, if you go to advanced audio properties for your microphone audio, make sure you select mono, because if it's not selected, mono is going to be stereo and it's going to come off only one speaker, either the left speaker or the right speaker. So make sure it's mono. Make sure you tell OBS, I want my mic to be dedicated to one channel, straight on, nothing more, nothing less. As far as desktop audio, you can leave it the same, but make sure your mic audio is selected to mono, otherwise it's not going to be the same. As far as the audio settings, pretty self-explanatory, like I said, not much you have got to do in there. Just make sure you have desktop audio selected correctly and your mic audio selected correctly, and now we go on to the next step. Okay, let's keep going forward with our OBS tutorial, our OBS settings here. Video, once again, this depends on your monitor. You can have a base scale of 1920, for example, and an output base of 2560, 1440. I don't recommend that unless you have a 1440 monitor. In this case, I have a 1080, a 1080. For the downscale filter, again, the better your computer is, the better the options are. I go with a sharpened scaling 36 samples. You should probably use that or use the bilinear one. It's in the middle there. I can't click on it because, again, I'm recording in OBS, so it's not gonna let me change it. The frame per second value, again, whatever your monitor is. Mine goes up to 75, but OBS only supports 60 or above 60, which I think next up is like 144. But OBS is only picking my monitor at 60 frames, so I got it at 60 frames. Nothing there to really worry about. Hotkeys are just hotkeys. These are things that, you know, you can play alongs. For example, if I press Control Shift G, the stream animation comes up, which is this one. Once again, become a part of the J-Army if you haven't already. And there it is. Make sure you like, hit that like button if this is helping you. But basically, this is what hotkeys are. You can, you know, dedicate certain hotkeys to mute, to show, not show, etc., so on and so forth. And last but not least, we go to the advanced settings. There's a few things you need to change here. Make sure your process priority is at high. Make sure your render is Direct 3D 11. Make sure your code format is NV12. Make sure your color space is 709, color range is full. So make sure you do that again, because these are going to be different by default, but make sure you do that because that's what is the best ones to go about it. Now, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and wrap up. Okay, so I've shown you what I record with OBS settings, and I've shown you literally all the steps and the stuff that I record with my OBS tutorial here. I've shown you what our scenes are and how my sources are for my scenes. I've shown you what my OBS settings are, and I've shown you how to go to the best settings for your situation. These are based on my experience. Some other people might have different ideas for it. These are what I think are the best ones. And last but not least, I've shown you what audio and how to configure your audio. Now, keep in mind, make sure you can configure your audio in the audio tab over here, but also make sure you right click on the gear and hit filters to configure the audio, add the filters, and also right click advanced audio properties to add the mono section. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I showed you all these things. What I want you to show me is how fast you can hit that like button and how fast you can subscribe to this channel, because I would really, really appreciate it. I plan on doing more of this stuff to kind of help the community out and kind of answer you guys' question, because I know a lot of you guys would like to start your own YouTube channel. I know a lot of you guys want to start your own YouTube channel but don't know where to start. Now, once again, Shadow Play is all good, Streamlabs OBS is all good, but OBS to me is the best. I tried Shadow Play and I tried Streamlabs OBS and I just couldn't get into them. I really did try to give them a shot, but Streamlabs to me has always been the best. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this has been an OBS tutorial for beginners, an OBS settings tutorial, if you will. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope to taught you something. My name is Yurtastic. With that being said, I am out. See you guys.